Tim Midget!
God, it must have been an effort writing the whole lyrics out for that.
Yeah, it was really nerve-wracking too, because I didn't want to muck it up. And we made that in... I was in quarantine in Perth in the height of COVID. I was in a friend's backyard and Yamaha gave me a piano and I
did it all for real.
Yeah,
excellent.
I desecrated. I sanded it back and everything. It was awesome.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, excellent commitment. But thanks. We're not here just to talk about that. You're about to tour. So,
Tour? I'm doing two gigs, yeah.
That's a tour?
I'm doing this Opera House Steps gig as part of the sort of beginning of their 50-year anniversary of that that wonderful building, and then I'm just doing a one-off gig in the St Kilda Palace foreshore, outdoor standing festival style. This is a series of concerts, outdoor concerts, and I'm doing one of them.
But you've got such broad work. Like, what do we get if we go to that gig? Which Tim Mitchell?
Well, it's not that my last tour was called Back, and my tours when I'm in theatres and I have people trapped and they can't leave and they're sitting in seats, I tend to talk a lot and sort of more stand-up-y and lecture-y and talk about logical philosophy and all that stuff I'm into. The outdoor gigs, I know you can't really guarantee that level of concentration. So I just, I think this is might be Darwin. We've sort of developed a festival set that's more songs and I'll just say whatever comes into my head and just keep the energy up. Yeah. And I think also post-COVID, I just really want to bring joy. I just want to make a bad Vance Joy pun now. I really have this sense that my shows have always had a bit of, like, politics in it and stuff, and I'll get back there, but for now I just don't you feel like it's... Yeah, we just need to just have a good time and get out and funk down.
Do you still perform barefoot?
Yeah. I've tried over the years to kind of go, OK, I'm a grown-up now.
Put
and, you know,
shoes on.
I've changed, you know, now I'm a composer and I'm taken more seriously, I should wear shoes. And I quite often have gone to wear shoes on stage and at the last minute I just go, this feels wrong. So I think I'm in it for life.
This is an ironic T-shirt then, isn't it?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, this is the only shoe I ever wear.
Are you singing White Wine in the Sun? Because that's Carrie's favourite. That's what she'll be doing from December through to 2023.
Most of the time. Listening to that song back to back. Yeah, it's 16 years old, that song. I know that because I wrote it for my daughter when she was 3 weeks
Crazy.
Old and time. But yeah, after about October I start throwing it into the back of the set and trying to get everyone a bit teary. And I mean it is amazing how that song, you know, because I never really had a record label and I've never been played on the radio for obvious reasons, and that song's like 5.5 minutes long. It's not a pop song. But just every year it's been this thing until I just sort of crept up and now a lot of people know it and a lot of people play it, and it never had a big push. It never had a big release or a record company, and it just grew, and I just love that.
Yeah. You do such a variety of things, Tim. I mean, is it still performing live? What really... get you going?
I think it's the thing that is most pure joy for me. I mean, it always takes work and rehearsal and all that, but when I'm on stage, I feel like $1 million bucks.
Nervous,
I feel like I belong there. Not very often these days. And there's a lot of satisfaction out of the projects that take a long time, writing a musical and making a TV show. It's so satisfying that it can live in the world. But my God, it's a lot of work, and it's quite nice to just go have a gig and have some wines and dance around.
Well, you'd be nervous when you perform at the Academy Awards next year because Matilda, the stage show that you obviously created, is now on Netflix. That could see you nominated for an Academy Award, couldn't it?
Seriously. Well, I wrote you can't get nominated for pre-existing songs, but I did write a new song for this feature film version. And I mean, they're going to put it up for nominations, so watch this space, and you can see me feel disappointed when I don't.
I think you'll be barefoot at the Oscars next year,
right? Go on, let's make that our next goal. Yeah.
Often recreations like this aim a bit higher in terms of age. My 3-year-old actually is obsessed with Matilda. It's all we watch in our house is the movie on repeat.
The American old one.
Yeah, right. Is this version aimed younger or older, or what is it?
It's very much a movie of our musical,
yes.
and that musical is a lot more loyal to Roald Dahl than the American movie was.
Yeah.
The American movie was a bit
of
Disney.
Course.
This is proper, you know, dark.
Yeah.
And
I
think like 7 or 8 year olds,
Okay.
It's very emotional. Yeah.
We're just about out of time, but can you explain yourself here? What is this?
That's me on the set of Upright Season 2, which is also coming out
really
in November.
Serious.
And, that's me in my makeup gown looking, frankly, incredible.
That's your Tinder profile pic,
that
yeah?
is. How do you know?
Of course. Well, you can see Tim Minchin live, possibly not like that, come November in Sydney and Melbourne. For details, please head to our website. Tim, been great to have you. Please thank Tim Minchin.
Thanks, guys.